I think what excites me most about FOSS is seeing the light go on in people's eyes, or the light bulb actually shows up above people's heads when you start to describe for the first time the capability of the technology.
There it is, yeah.
It gives them real-time information which they never had before.
Instead of using electricity, we're using optical light. We're now using a laser to shine the laser light down this optical fiber. And in this optical fiber, we have these things called Bragg gratings, which are these little optical mirrors that are located down the length of the fiber. And when we shine that laser light down that optical fiber, those little mirrors will reflect back a little signature. We track those signatures, and as they change, we can calibrate those changes to engineering parameters, something like strain, something like temperature. And instead of a change in resistance like we would with a strain gauge, we use a change in the wavelength of the light of each of those little reflectors coming back in that optical fiber.
Prior to FOSS, we were using conventional strain gauges, and the installer of the strain gauge would actually go out to your structure, whether it be an airplane wing, whether it be a fuselage, whatever the case may be. They would install each one of these individual gratings onto the structure.
So imagine having your arm have one measurement, and you wouldn't be able to feel anything else around it. It's kind of limiting. Same thing structurally. You don't have a lot of insight into what's going on in the structure if you have a sensor every several feet. The FOSS technology allows you to have a sensor every quarter inch along the single optical fiber. That allows you to look more and more like a biological system. That FOSS can save time on your schedule for installing sensors. It can give you greater insight and much more spatial fidelity in your measurement system than ever before.
In 20 years, the hope is that we would see this on commercially available aircraft. We would see it on expendable launch vehicles. We see them on windmills for efficiency. We see them on automobiles, medical applications, catheters, health procedures.
It could also measure liquid level, magnetic field, and it goes on and on.
21 strain measurements, 1,400 strain measurements on a single fiber.
This NASA technology and many others are ready to be transferred to your business. Find out more by visiting technology.nasa.gov.